Hello friends, in this video we will see the second part of the series of videos that we are being doing for environmental current affairs. And before going to the video, I want you to do three things. The first thing is that take a Nautilus and please keep it beside you, so that whenever we are discussing an environment location, you should see the location of that area in the map. The second is that please keep a tab open for your Wikipedia or your environmental book or any other material or notes that you have for environment, so that when we are discussing the current affairs, you should see the relevance of that current affairs to the topic that is there in the syllabus. If you are going for Wikipedia, please do not go and research in Wikipedia the first four lines, my friends, first four lines. The third thing is that keep a tab or keep something for noting down important keywords. Many had asked me for referring all these PDFs for the exam, but I would suggest very less number of days are there for prelims. There is no time left. So the keywords, if you are having a topic, we are discussing a topic, have the keywords noted down. Only one in a topic, maybe five words you should note it down, which are essential. And that, with that, you should go into the and revise and go into the examination hall, and you will be able to write the exam very clearly. Do not worry, you will remember everything. Do not worry that you are going to forget anything, because at this moment everyone will feel that I have forgotten everything. But I can assure you very well that till the moment when you step inside the examination hall, you will feel that you have forgotten. But when you go inside the examination hall, even the memories starting from the first day of your life will actually come back to you on the examination hall. So do not panic, do not worry. Yes, it will feel that we have forgotten everything, but I can assure you, my friends, that you will even look into the future and you will be able to gather points even from the future. Your brain has that capacity of dragging points from wherever possible. Your brain, the power, I will say this, you will see the power of your brain inside the examination hall. So let us go into the video. We will start with this concept called as very important in news, but what is important for us? So we'll start like that. Okay, so what is this Gajayatra? This Gajayatra was in news. So what they see, and when you are reading Gajayatra, Gajayatra means nothing, in the sense that there is elephant corridors. Okay, elephant corridors, in the sense very important, because elephants actually they have these places. This is place one, this is place two, but they have this habit of going from here to here. So this corridor is called as elephant corridor. What happens is that we build houses here, structures here, all across this villages here, and hence that is why man-animal conflict happens. And hence this Gajayatra. Gaja means elephant, yatra means you are walking, pilgrimage or something. Okay, you are nadakkirathu. Okay, so what you have to know is that this is a campaign which is done in India to help or to give information about this elephant corridors, to make it proper. Okay, who does that? You should know who does that. That is the point. It is done by Wildlife Trust of India. See, this is the thing. It is done by Wildlife Trust of India. The second important thing in this article is that, see, India has by far the largest number. See, the largest number of ancient elephants. Two elephants, one is in Africa, African elephant. If you see, that is what in many South African movies and all, if you see, English movies, if you see, they will have this very huge tandam, and in the sense, what to say, tandam, the teeth, very big thing, right? So it will have that. Okay, but Asian elephant is different. You check that. Okay, you check. There is a small difference between Asian elephant and African elephant. Two are of elephants only, but two different species. Okay, so but India has the largest Asian elephants. This is the point. India has the largest Asian elephants. No, and it is India. Okay, endangered. You need not know. Largest number, not the. See, they will give the statement. Only India has Asian elephant. But India only Asian elephant? No, India is the largest. It's true. Okay, largest. It's true. African elephant. Please check that. Okay, in Wikipedia, please check what is African. So here, WTA, Wildlife Trust of India, does this Gajayatra for this elephant corridor. But here in the information, this two key information, Asian elephant, African elephant, but India has this Asian elephant largest number, but not only. Okay, but UPSC will say only India has Asian elephant, but no, see this largest number only. Okay. Next is this. This is what they asked in 2020 preliminary examination. They said that the number of elephants is very high in Kerala, or the meaning is that three four statements were given. Which of the above following is true about elephants they gave, and four statements they gave. In that one statement, if you see, one statement is the Kerala has the largest number of elephants. No, this is wrong. Actually, in 2020 paper, if you remove this option, you will directly get the correct answer. Okay, you will get the correct answer. But you should know which is the largest, you know. So the largest states, you see, states with highest elephant population, it is not Kerala, it is Karnataka, Assam. Second is Assam, then Kerala. So first is, second is, third. This is what they asked. Fourth is Tamil Nadu. Please check this. Okay, please check this. Okay. Next, so but you have to know what is this Wild Trust India. What is this Wild Trust India? Wildlife Trust of India, very important. See, 1998, they will say it is a government organization. This is what they will say. They will say it is works under the ministry or government organization. It was found by the government. See, Wildlife Trust of India, conservation of wildlife. It is a team of 150 dedicated professionals. It was started. See, this is the point. 50 professionals. They started it because of the enthusiasm of protection of conservation of wildlife and the habitat. So this is the thing you have to know. But why I have kept this is because of two things. One is Gajayatra. Gajayatra is done by WTA. This was in the news. And the next is because this was in the news. See, CWRC in Kaziranga. So your job now is to see where is Kaziranga. So that you have to know. Please check that Kaziranga in what is now. I will tell you what is CWRC and Kaziranga also. But check the map. Where is Kaziranga? Where it is? Why this? Because see, every year UPSC asks simple national park only. We actually do not, we think that national park list is very high and we leave all these questions. But simple national park, very important national park, at least we have to know, right? Kaziranga is important, and the CWRC program in Kaziranga is going into the 20th year. And see this, it is in 20th year. August, see when it is August, it's August 2021. Very close to our prelims, this might come. Please check that. And what you have to know, what is the CWRC? See, this is Center for Wildlife Rehabilitation and Conservation. Simple. Center for Wildlife, that is what, Center for Wildlife Rehabilitation, Center Rehabilitation and Conservation. It is done in by Assam Forest Department partners. These are the, see, actually WTI, Wildlife Trust of India. So I have taken this information from Wildlife Trust of India. Wildlife Trust of India plus Assam Department plus International Fund for Animal Welfare. So it is a collaboration of all three done where? See where? It is done in Kaziranga National Park. See, that is why I asked you to see where is Kaziranga National Park. What this sent the wildlife, see the meaning itself, what it says, it is rehabilitation and conservation center. That is, any animals, they will be injured and they will be orphaned or something, and they will be rehabilitated in these centers and they will be left. okay, in the file. So this is the 20th year. See, this is the 20th year, and it's very important key, I think, very important. And see, that is why I said this is that it's a very important thing you have to see amply. See, why see this UNESCO site? Earlier I said a UNESCO site Ken Betwa link, okay, in that I said Sanchi Stupa Bimbetka. Here another UNESCO site, Kaziranga National Park, very very important, flanked by Brahmaputra River towards its north. See, the questions will be Brahmaputra River, where it flows, or Kaziranga, where it is. Brahmaputra River flows in the south of Kaziranga. So, like that they will give. See, that this is the thing you have to know. Kaziranga, where it lies. You have to see the map question and you have to find this. Okay. So, and the question, you know what they ask. Why Kaziranga is very very important. See, why Kaziranga is very important means it has the largest population of, see this word again, largest population of greater one-horned rhinoceros. And see, Kaziranga also has this endangered Royal Bengal tiger. See, another point. See, two questions are there in this slide. What the two questions are? Royal Bengal tiger, we would assume, see, Royal Bengal tiger, okay, actually Ganguly, that is why Ganguly was kind of actually matched with this Royal Bengal tiger. It is in Bengal, okay, Bengal, Sundarbans. But actually it also lies, see, that is what they also lie in this Kaziranga park. So we will think that it is Assam, it is Bengal tiger, in Assam it is not there. Kaziranga is in Assam, so it will not be there. No. See, Bengal tiger, it is given, it is there in Kaziranga as well. And the next, the most important question which was asked in 2020, and every year they keep asking this, one-horned rhinoceros. Kaziranga has the largest, okay, largest, please underline the word, largest population of great one-horned rhinoceros, but not the only place, okay, India. So what they gave, you know, India is the only country, okay, only country to have one horned rhinoceros. It is in Kaziranga, okay, but one horned rhinoceros, whether it is only in India, no. See this distribution, this is the distribution. If you are able to see this distribution, it is in Nepal. See, it is in Nepal. It is in Nepal. See, it is over the one horned rhinoceros. See, we have this restriction of national boundaries, but animals do not have this restriction of national boundaries. But see, one animal has, which is Asiatic lion. It is in Gir. This was the question. See, UPSC does this magic. It's a massive. How they take all these questions beautifully, I do not know. They gave three statements. India has Asiatic lion is present only in India. Second statement I forgot, and one-horned rhinoceros is present only in India. This is wrong. One-horned rhinoceros is not present only in India, my friends, because it is present in Nepal and Bhutan also. See this. But Asiatic lion is only in India. It is in Gir, okay, Gujarat. See, this is an important, that is how they take questions. They do not, and that is why I think I keep repeating this. Mock interviews, preliminary question papers, people actually get low marks. Why? Because these logic and all would not be there in these mocks. UPSC question is a scientific paper. UPSC question is a beautiful scientific paper. So that is why I ask you to trust what you are studying. Mock test, yes, important. Yes, very important. Write them, understand the question, what are all the wrongs, correct them, complete the portion, move on. Do not sit with the mock test marks. Your marks in UPSC is important, okay? Because UPSC has this very nice scientific question. See this, but see the purpose now, one-horned rhinoceros is in Kaziranga and Royal Bengal tiger is there. Asian elephant is also there. See this. Asian elephant is there and it is present. See how they are distributed. They are, and see another question, geography question. This is geography question. This is geography. In geography, they will ask. They will say, subtropical grassland. One-horned rhinoceros, where they live in this grassland, savanna, shrubland. Okay. Next, see the why international. So when we read this, because see WTA is partnering with Assam Department and this International Fund for Wildlife, and hence I have made this. So what is this International Fund for Animal Welfare? They are not a government organization. This is a non-profit NGO, which was founded in 1969, largest animal welfare organization in the world. So this is like Wildlife Trust of India only for international. Okay, Wildlife Trust of India 1998, right? This is WTA, Wildlife Trust of India, and this is 1969. Okay, 1969 International Fund for Animal Welfare. Both are kind of an NGO which are working with the Assam Department in Kaziranga. And second, see, Wildlife Trust of India does another. See, this is next very important question. See, Greater Manas Conservation Project. Okay, actually, I took it in context with this Center for Wildlife. So I saw in Center for Wildlife Rehabilitation Center in Kaziranga something is going on. Manas is actually very close to it, right? Manas is very close. Whether they are doing something there means, yes, Greater Manas Conservation Project, they are doing this. But what we have to see, this is the point you have to know. What is Manas, you know? What are the types of forest in Manas? This is the question they will ask, my friends. What are the types of forest in Manas? There are five major forest type. Evergreen forest, very important. See, note it down. There are all types. Evergreen forest, moist deciduous. Whether dry deciduous, no. It's moist deciduous. It's a jog. See, that is what this is. Geography. When we are reading, that is why in our table of schedule, I made geography and environment together. If you remember that schedule, why? Because when you are reading environment, you should also finish this. See, moist deciduous and semi-evergreen. See, wet alluvial also is there. Alluvial grassland. See, all types of forests. See, what are the five types? Please look at it. Or evergreen, moist deciduous, wet alluvial grassland, or semi-evergreen. This five, please remember, this can be asked as a question. Also, you know why they keep asking this Manas, every paper is very, very, or they keep asking this Manas question, because you know, it's an UNESCO site. The other UNESCO sites we have discussed, Kaziranga we have discussed, Bimbetka, go and see, Sanchi Stupa, please see. But UNESCO, Manas is an UNESCO site, but it is also a tiger reserve. It is also a national park. It's also a elephant reserve. Fifth, it is also a biosphere reserve. It's an UNESCO site. It's a tiger reserve. It's a national park. It's an elephant reserve. It's a biosphere reserve. So it is our duty to go and check where is Manas National Park. You have to please check it now and please do that. And the Wildlife Trust, again, this is done by Wildlife Trust of India with the help of International Fund for Animal Welfare. But this time, see this Arunachal Pradesh. See, I am not taking Assam. This Pake Conservation Project is in Arunachal Pradesh. So, you know, what they will ask, see, this is what they will ask. Kaziranga is here. Manas is somewhere in Assam here. You know where Pake is? This Pake is in this Tawang area. I will show you where. See, this is the question they asked. Or Pakui, I think, if I am pronouncing something wrong also, because sometimes, see, in the fast when I am making these things, pronunciation does go wrong. Okay, please check this in Pake, where it is. It is here. This was asked in prelims. What they are having this bear rehabilitation. Two questions. They are having this bear rehabilitation center in Pake. Second, you should know in Himalayas bears are present. This is the point. UPSC will ask. So we might think that bears are present in the open grassland or something, but bears are present in the Himalayas. Okay, you should know that. And see this Asiatic black bear. Okay, Asiatic black bear. What is present in India? Asiatic black bear. Four species are found in India. four species are found in India. See again, four species are found where this Asiatic black bear, the distribution you have to see. Distribution, see this in the Himalayas extending from Jammu Kashmir to the Arunachal Pradesh in the east. So this is very, very important. That is, see, like this one-horned rhinoceros, this black bear is also present, right? Black bear is present. Back in where? Parque Conservation Reserve. See, this Wildlife Protection Act. Okay, Wildlife Protection Act. I think we discussed in the first video this is an important act. This bear is protected in this important act, and according to Schedule 2, you don't have to know this, but there are 6 schedules. Check, because 2020 they asked one question from this 6th schedule. That is, what these schedules do, please check that. Each has one thing. The last maybe is called as a vermin, or vermin means anything added to that schedule, you can kill that. Okay? And there is a schedule, 5th or 6th schedule, that was the question. Okay, it is for plants. Okay, plants which cannot be grown. So that is what UPSC gave as a statement. Plants which cannot be grown are included in that schedule. But that is a plant which can be grown with permission. That is the answer. Okay, so this is how they will give. But when we are very well versed with this 6th schedule, we can answer that simple. Why I kept this package is that, see, Center for Bears Rehabilitation, Arunachal Pradesh, WTI, 2012, and with the help of wildlife or this international fund for animal welfare is done. Where is this Parque? See, it is situated on the west bank of Parque, because see why it is called as Parque Wildlife Sanctuary, and it is also a tiger reserve, my friend. It is situated in Arunachal Pradesh. Very, very important. Where is Parque Wildlife Reserve, Wildlife Sanctuary, Tiger Reserve? They will ask this question. Please check it, my friends. Check it. There it is. And wildlife, see, again, Wildlife Trust of India does this One Rakshak project, or protection of one. One Rakshak means protection. So the one means forest protection. Rakshak means protection project. So they do this also. Wildlife crime prevention training, many things. See, again, where is this Dudhwa? See, go check this. Parque, okay, but where is this Dudhwa? Dudhwa is in Uttar Pradesh. Okay, this is the, see, this is how they will ask question. They will ask question, where does UPSC ask all these questions? Please check that. Dudhwa, where it is. Okay, and next, this is another, this coastal regulation zone. Okay, current affairs it was there. What is this coastal, they made some amendments in this coastal regulation zone. That is because in the coast areas, what construction people have to do, many things are there. But why I kept this is that you have to know this coastal regulation zone is, I said that Wildlife Protection Act is important act. Wildlife Protection Act is an important act. The next very important act is Environment Protection Act. These two acts are very, very important. Environment Protection Act. This two is very, very important, my friends, 1986. These two are the key questions UPSC keeps asking. Why I gave this coastal regulation zone slide is that this coastal regulation zone is passed under this Environmental Protection Act. This is what you have to know. Okay? It's not Wildlife Protection Act. They'll give you Wildlife Protection Act under CRZ. Is passed under Wildlife Protection Act. No, it's Environmental Protection Act. Next is this question. Okay, they asked this question. One question, National Green Tribunal. In 2012, this question was there. Under which article? Whether Article 19, Article 21, or Article 22, or Article 25. Something. They gave a list of articles. This was the question. They gave a list of articles and said, National Green Tribunal was passed under which article? Actually, it is Article 21, Right to Life. So, Article 21, Right to Life. And as you might be aware, this Right to Life ambit has been increased, and there are so many rights, secularism, democracy, elections, everything has been added in this Right to Life, because the Supreme Court has said that Right to Life is not mere animal existence, and it is a right to live with dignity. So, when you are having a right to live with dignity, you have the right to a proper environment as well. and when proper environment, if you have to give means, you have to have a tribunal or a court giving you that protection of clean environment. But see this, it is a first point you should know, it is not, it is a statutory body. Okay, it is a statutory body. See this, it is a statutory. See, this is what UPSC will give. This is a executive body, they will say. This tribunal is an executive tribunal. No, there is a statute, that is a, there is a law for that. National Green Tribunal. This is the question they will ask. This question they have already asked. Under Article 21 they have passed. But they will say it is not a statutory act. No, no, National Green Tribunal is a statutory act. Protection of, see, protection and conservation of forest, this and all you should know. And you should know, second point, it is not like a normal Supreme Court, High Court. This is a tribunal. So procedure laid down. See, this tribunal not bound by procedure. See, other tribunals also like this only. Supreme Court and High Court is different. Tribunal is different. Here, this procedure laid down in this code of, no, it will not work. This is the, they will say, this is the, these are the things they will say. So three, and fifth is this, the NGT is proposed to sit in five places. So the main thing is in Delhi. When you go for, say, Delhi, Bhopal, Pune, so have this in your mind, Pune, Kolkata, and one is in Chennai. So Delhi, if you go for interview, if you go, and when you go, you will actually, you can see that tribunal. For you can just roam around, you'll see it is very near. And the next important question, see, next important question is under what, see, what and all the statute is, see, it is a statutory body, but what and all law this environmental tribunal will deal. They are dealing with these specific seven laws. See this, anything which happens or any problem happens in these laws, you can go to the tribunal. So what are the Environmental Protection Act, Biological Diversity Act, see, Public Liability Insurance Act, Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act, Water Prevention and Control and Pollution Act 1974, Forest Conservation Act, these seven acts, please check that, please check that, these seven acts, when there is a problem in these seven acts, you can go to National Green Tribunal. They will give some other thing. They will give maybe Wildlife Protection Act. Wildlife Protection Act is not here. Environmental Protection Act is only here. Okay. So next important thing is this snow leopard. See, we have already seen Kaziranga National Park, Manas National Park, Pake bear, four species of bear. This snow leopard is very important. Okay. What they will say, you know, the snow leopard is present only in India. See this, see the distribution. This is the distribution. It is going inside China, Urumqi. So it is going, see, all over, see, and it's also over Nepal, Bhutan, everything. See, everywhere it is there. See, all over the, see, Himalayan snow leopard. It is there. So wherever the transport, that is what I said. Human beings have this habit of having this nation's boundary, but animals do not have. And one-horned rhinoceros, that was the question. One-horned rhinoceros only in India? No. One-horned rhinoceros is distribution we saw. It is also present in Nepal, Bhutan. Same is the case with snow leopard. Please check this. Leopard conservation is very important topic. They asked, it's in current affairs. So it was, this is Project Snow Leopard. Okay, Project Snow Leopard. And back, see, Project Snow Leopard, you should know, they will say that only one state, okay, but where it is, see, I have included this because they asked once this red panda, whether red panda is in Himalayas, they asked this question, okay, I was not sure, but red, see this, snow leopard, I have said that it is in the Himalaya transboundary, see, including the Himalaya and the transboundary, that zone, the distribution we saw here. And you should also know, red panda is also, wolf is there, this, okay, bear, this bear is what we saw, Pake, you remember this, Pake, this area, Pake Tawang area, Pake conservation site, where WTA, Wildlife Trust of India, has this conservation site for bears. Bear is ursus something. So it also has this protection of, or it, so in the sense that Himalayas also has this snow leopard, also has this red panda. Please check that, please check that. and Project Leopard. So where and all Project Leopard is there? See, all the states, they will say some, they will leave some state, but all the, this is Himalayas. This is actually not states, Himalayas, all the Himalayas. But Assam is not there. Please check it. Assam is not there. See, where the protected areas for snow leopard is, it's in the Himalayan zone. Assam is in the plains, so it is not there. Please check that. Please check that. The name is not there, so please, this is the question. So thank you for watching this video, and anyone who has not liked it, please do like it, share it, subscribe it, and all the best for your preliminary examination. Thank you. Thank you.